Welcome back. So in the last video, I started to take a stab at deriving this maximum efficiency for solar energy conversion. And this is a very pertinent question that has been lingering around since several videos. So what I did in last video, I derived this Carnot efficiency limit, which is a very important limit. And let me put it in a box. And what it says is that for this ideal Carnot kind of engine, the maximum efficiency for converting this energy of sunlight, which I denoted in this red color, into useful form of work, which I denoted by this green color, is related to the temperature of the ambient and the temperature of the sun. And it was given by this formula. So if I plug in a value of ambient temperature of 300 Kelvin and temperature of the sun to be 6000 Kelvin, this efficiency comes out to be approximately 95%. But I said, I also stated that this Carnot efficiency can never be achieved for a solar energy conversion. So why did I make that statement? The reason I made that statement is because there are two things we need to correct in this formalism if we need to take into account a converter which is converting this solar energy into a useful form of work. So what are those two corrections? The first one is that I stated that the entropy which is coming due to this energy flux coming from the sun is given by ES divided by the temperature of the sun. In fact, this is not true for this energy coming from the sun, which happens to be in the form of this radiation, which is given by Planck's law, is not ES by TS, but there's a factor of 4 by 3. So there's a factor of 4 by 3, which essentially increases this this entropy flux by 33% as compared to what you would get if this energy was coming through a medium. So let me derive this first. Where does this factor of 4 by 3 come from? So let me move on this side so I have more space for this derivation. So I know that the fundamental definition of entropy is defined by this definition, where this entropy flux is related to the energy flux by this definition. Also, I know that for a radiation which is coming from a black body, the total energy flux, the total energy in that radiation can be related to the temperature of the black body, and it's proportional to the T to the power 4, or the fourth power of the temperature of the black body. And this proportionality constant is what we call as the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. In fact, this relationship is called as the Stefan-Boltzmann's law. So now I can take this equation, and I can take a differentiation with respect to temperature. So when I take a derivative, I'll get a dE, and I'll take a derivative with respect to temperature. So I'll get a coefficient of 4 over here, and I'll get a temperature coefficient. I'll get a temperature power of 3 over here. So now I can use that and plug that into this equation over here. So I can take my dE and write it as this formula, and I can plug that over here. So if I do that, then I get a relationship which relates my entropy flux to the temperature as given by this formula. So I'll have a power of 3 over here, and that will get divided by this temperature in the denominator over here. So I get a power of 2 on my temperature. And this gives me the derivative with respect to temperature. So now I can further integrate this with respect to temperature, and I can make use of the fact that entropy at zero temperature is equal to zero. So I can integrate this over temperature from zero Kelvin to a certain temperature, and that will essentially give me this formula where my entropy comes out to be 4 by 3. So if I integrate this power of 2, I get a third power in temperature, and I get a coefficient of 1 by 3. And this entropy is given by this formula. Now I can relate it back to the energy. I know that this term for energy is related to the temperature by this equation, and I can plug that back in over here. So I can essentially plug that back in here and write this as T to power 4 divided by T. And now this term is nothing but the energy associated with that radiative flux. So now I can see that my entropy is given by this formula, where it's related to the energy coming from this radiation by this formula, where I have a factor of 4 by 3. And so it kind of makes sense. So energy for a radiative process, or you know, whenever you have a radiation which is traveling without any medium, is given by 4 by 3 times energy associated with that radiation divided by the temperature of the black body. So if I contrast this with the entropy formula that I had used previously, I see that the entropy associated now is more, is given by this factor of 4 by 3. And also this energy flux, when it's once it's radiated from the black body, so once this radiation happens from the black body, this entropy flux essentially remains a constant, versus in this case where my entropy is getting transferred through a medium, this there must be a source of this heat and there's a sink of this heat, and the temperature constantly varies. So the temperature is higher at the source and the temperature is lower at the sink. So as the energy moves from the source to the sink, this entropy flux changes, which is opposite to the case of this in the case of radiation from the black body, where the flux or this entropy is associated when this radiation is emitted, and once this emission or when this radiation propagates through this free space, then the entropy remains the same. So now, you know, that's a good detour into the world of entropy, but let's now come back to this case of solar energy conversion. So now what I'm interested in doing over here is that I've corrected for this entropy flux. So I know that it's now there's a factor of 4 by 3 associated with it. Now I need to make one more correction, and that one more correction is concerned with you know, the fact that this converter or this cell, and let me call this as a, you know, let me associate a temperature with this cell, and let me call it TC. So now this temperature is, you know, this temperature, there's a finite temperature associated with the cell, and this cell itself is also going to emit out radiation. So it's going to emit out radiation. Since this cell, you know, I can approximate it as a black body as well. So this is a black body at a temperature of TC. And now there will be essentially an energy associated due to radiation coming out from the cell. And I denote that again by this red arrow, and I denote it by this symbol EC, where this energy is associated with this radiation coming from the cell. And correspondingly with this radiation, of course, there will be a entropy flux associated as well. And I can write that entropy flux associated with this radiation again by this newly derived formula, where this is also like a black body radiation. So it's going to be related by this energy of the flux divided by the temperature of the body which is emitting this radiation. So divided by the temperature of the cell. So now this is this gives me the framework for deriving this what is called as the Landsberg limit for energy conversion of the solar cell. And I'll complete that derivation in the next video. So see you in the next video.